Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video, I will be talking about one of the challenges when building our mobile apps at scale. It's the deep link. But in the beginning, let's talk about what is the deep link. Mobile app deep link is the ability to link into a specific page inside of a native iOS or Android mobile app. It lets you open up a specific content page and burst through custom data, for example, promo codes. The implementation of iOS and Android deep link is different. For example, in iOS, we are using universal links and URL schemas, but for Android, it's based on intents. Mobile app deep link is a technology that launches an app and opens a specific page once a user clicks a URL on a web page or in another application, and it brings seamless user experience. Because that, testing deep links is important. For Android, for example, we can use Espresso, the native testing tool from Google. In this example, we have the activity test rule because we are using Espresso and passing our main activity to this rule. Then after that, we will start specifying the URI with the deep links that we have. And then after that, we will use the intent to be able to start our activity rule by launching the activity and passing the intent to this activity. And the result will be that the application will be launched, but with a specific URL or the URL that we are specifying in the deep links or in the URI. And for iOS, we can use XCUITest, the native tool from Apple, by launching the app and register the deep link with Safari, like the example that we have, and wait the app to enter the foreground. So here we are asserting that Safari is open the deep link, wait for existence, and then with the link, we are clicking on the link, and then after that, we are clicking on the button to open this link. Then we are asserting that the app is already opened. After we finished our test, we can run our UI test locally or through the CI/CD pipelines. For example, here I already prepared my CI/CD workflow on Bitrise. And here I add two steps for running my UI test. One for building the Android for UI test, which give me the APK and the test APK or our test cases. And then I have the virtual device testing, which will take the two APKs and upload them to the Firebase test lab and selecting the test device that I want. And also the test type will be instrumentation test. And then after that, I can run my scripts and then I can check the test report. And for iOS, here also I have one predefined step for XCUITest for iOS. And also here I can specify the device and the OS version or the platform. And also I can prepare my application by adding the required step for building my dependencies, like run CocoaBot or Cartridge, and then after that I can run my test cases, and also I can check the test report after the workflow finished, and also I can send Slack messages to the developers or the test engineers with the test result. I hope that you enjoyed the video and see you in the next challenge. Bye bye.